Welcome to module 5.4. In this 5.4, we will talk about the coding of pass 1 of the assembler. So, what is required as we see here is that, so in your system, you just enter assembler myproc.asm. Now, what we will do is in pass 1, this will create an intermediate file called myproc.inter. That will be taken again as input by pass 2 and it will create your myproc.hack, which is the 16-bit binary. So, this is the two pass assembly stages. So, what we need to do as a part of pass 1, already we have explained that it needs to populate the symbol table. It has to look for symbols, and for all the symbols that are seen there, it needs to make, it needs to find a mapping to an address. And that address is what the pass 2 will do to basically get the binary, right. So, what will pass 1 do? It will read line by line the code. First, it will initialize symbol table. What is initialization of the symbol table? We have seen in module 5.3, right. So, there will be some 23 entries. We have to do that, and the remaining things have to be null and minus 1, all those things we have seen. Now, every line, what it does, this particular pass 1 will take your myproc.asm file and it will read every line. And in that line, if there are comments, it will remove. First, it will remove white space. Suppose I have, say, d equal to a plus m, lot of white space. This still, your system has to allow this, right? So, we will now make it as d equal to a plus m, removing all the white spaces that are, you know, at this part, this part, this part, this part. So, we now remove the white space. After removing the white space, you will just have the command. Now, at that point, you could have, and after you remove the white space, now we have to see if it is a comment or not. The second thing is to remove a comment. So, comment, there are two challenges. One thing is I could start with a comment, everything is a comment there in the assembly, then you ignore that entire line. As I told you, comments are to be ignored, there is no binary equivalent for a comment, okay. So, we just ignore it. The other thing is I could have d equal to a plus m and I could have something like updating memory. So, when we do this, what will happen is, when you remove all the white spaces, this would have become d equal to a plus m slash slash updating memory, right. So, you, if just there were a comment, the first two characters itself would be slash slash, and you could, because you have removed all the white spaces, then you can ignore the entire comment. But in this case, I will just scan till d equal to a plus m. The first time I see the two double slash, just do not parse anything beyond this. And so, you are basically reading a string. You read line by line and put it as a string. So, you just make, so what would have happened? Let us say this is a parsed command you are reading. So, what would have happened here is, this will be passed command of 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, d equal to a plus m, right. The 5 characters are already there. Then the 6th and 7th, you see it is a comment, just to make that 5th character as the null character. So, the string ends here, d equal to a plus m ends here, right. So, that is something that we need to be very careful about comment, okay. So, you remove white space, remove comment. For every line by line you read, remove white space, remove comment. Now, the next thing is, now we have to find the type of comment. Now, since I have removed all the white spaces and also the comments, if I say the first character is going to be this parenthesis, then obviously this is going to be a label comment, or what you call as an L comment. So, there is a label. That means, for pass 1, it is very, very important. I have to take whatever symbol is there within that label and try to add the entry and do, right. So, that is an L command. Now, to make this a little bit robust, I could have this loop Before we go there, so this is one L command. Another thing is that the first character itself, since again, look, I have removed all the white spaces, right? If the first character is at that you have read, then you know that this is a command. Then you go and check whether this is a constant. So whatever is following till the end of line in this particular string, please check if it is going to be zeros and ones. Digits, then it essentially becomes a constant. If the first thing starts with alphabet or anything other than zeros and ones, anything other than a numeric number, then you know that this is again a symbol. So then you have at symbol. Now we have to go to that symbol table and see if add it and do whatever we have described earlier, right? So now we know it's a L command. I know if it's an add command with a symbol, I have to take that symbol and keep adding it to the symbol table. Now, the last thing is that to make it a little more robust, I could have something like this. I could have a symbol, say loop, and then I could have some at, right? At I, or I could have loop and I will have at 100. I will have loop and I will have some d equal to d plus m or something. So, I could have an L followed by an A which has a symbol, A also has a symbol, or L followed by A with as a constant, or L followed by a C type instruction. Remember, we have A type and C type instructions, right? So, in this case, again, since we have removed all the white spaces, etcetera, this will be looking like loop. Immediately, I will have an at and then something, or I will have loop and immediately I will have a non-at, right? So, this also to just make your assembler little more robust. We introduce this. So, then basically we need to understand this loop, this symbol, and then if this is a symbol, both of these symbols have to be updated in the symbol table. And in the symbol table, you will find whether address is already entered with address minus 1, already entered with some address already fixed. So these are the things. So this is how we resolve the symbols as a part of pass 1. So, after doing this line by line and after you reach the end of the file, right? So, we basically go and check. The last thing that we see is that there will be some more symbols for which we have not assigned the address, and those are the non-labels, these are the data, right? We have already seen in module 5.3, and those data points we basically go and put address starting from something like 16 or 17. We just put those addresses and fill it up, right? So, this is what the basic table does. This is what the basic pass 1 of your assembler does. So, at the end of this, you will have a uncommented or comment removed, decommented, that is a correct word, a decommented, de white spaced file, wherein all your comments and white space are removed. You give an input.asm and you get this. Along with that, so this is what, this is the inter file. I said myproc.inter, right? That inter file is nothing but this myproc.inter that we are seeing here is nothing but all your comments removed and this, plus in addition your entire symbol table is filled. All the symbols that are used in that program has an associated address. So, this is how, this is pass 1 of your assembler, and very quickly I will go through the code so that you get an understanding. So, the one of the important thing is we said, right, as we see here, I want assembler myproc.asm. So that's the name of the file is basically given as an argument in your command line. So that warrants some very interesting C construct. I hope many of you know that there's something called argc argv. If you don't know this, it's very important that you know this. So please go to one of our Google sites or Wikipedia, and you will find lot of tutorials on this. So this is the way you accept a command line parameter in the C program. Now, then you go and you initialize. So one of the things that we need very quickly, as you see here, we need to have an instruction number. We need to have a line number. We have already seen why we need an instruction number. So, right in the module 5.2, when we look at a symbol, when I look at a label with parentheses, immediately I have to assign the instruction number plus 1 for that, right? Then only that's how I resolve the symbol, right? So we need to maintain the instruction number and line number here. And what we do here is that we read one command after command, that we call as next command. The parsed command is nothing but all your comments removed and your white space removed. Your parse command is all your white space removed here, right? So I define these two things, and you know this is called a buffer. So I have something like 80 characters per line. So I put a limit on that. Now I initialize the symbol table. So I put all those 23 entries, etc. As I can. And now I am going to, the most important thing is I am reading one by one the commands. One by one after that, and I use this function called fgetters to do that. And in this part of the code, I am removing all the white spaces, and I am also removing all the, if there are comments inside a line, I am using this while loop to remove all the comments. So the, and then I am finding the command type. It can be an L command or a L and A command or a L and C command, right? And then what I do is, if it is an L command or any of these commands, I basically extract the symbol and add that, I try and add that symbol into the symbol table, right? I add that symbol into the symbol table. And similarly, if it is an L and A command, and then I basically have to, you know, after the so L and A command will look like one symbol with the parenthesis, and then immediately your A command will show. So I go to that part, and after that at symbol, I go and find out if it's again another symbol. So at, I can have symbol, right? So I go and find that, and that if it is a symbol, again I add it to the. I do this add entry into the symbol table. The last is that if it is just an A command, right? If it is just an A command, I just basically see if after the at symbol is the character between 0 and 9. If it is not between 0 and 9, then it's a symbol. Then again, I do the same thing as I have seen, right? So, after finishing all these things, this is very, very important that I scan every entry of my max entries of my symbol table, and if I find that if one of the addresses is minus 1, but my entry is slash 0 is not null, it's not null. So, I have a valid string. Nullness, but the entry is minus 1. This, as I explained earlier, could happen in the case of what? In the case of symbol data points, right? Like at I, at which are non-symbols point. So those things, I start at assigning addresses starting from 16, right? And I keep incrementing. So this is end of pass 1. So where I close the input file and the inter file. Now I have got an inter file. What I write into the inter file is the completely decommented D white spaced thing, right? And this is pass one of the code. So, in the next module, we will see how we are going to go about pass two.